Alright, so today on Repairs 101, I thought I'd show you the procedure for making standard double flares using double wall steel tubing. We're going to make some brake lines. Stick around. Okay, so, you know, the first thing I got to say is that your brakes are the most important system on your vehicle. You know, it doesn't have to start, and it doesn't have to turn. It doesn't have to have a kick-ass stereo. It just needs to be able to stop. So you need to be absolutely sure that you're using the correct type of fitting, the correct type of line, and the correct type of fluids for that matter. If you don't know what kind of fluid to use, look in your vehicle's owner's manual, or sometimes the information will be right there on the cap of the master cylinder under the hood.
Okay, well, it'd be fair to ask, first of all, what does a single flare look like? Okay, so here's a single flare with the flare nut on it. Give you an idea of what that looks like. As you can see, the flare on the tubing matches the flare on the fitting, and they lock together. Perfectly good fitting for low pressure, but not for high pressure applications. So you can buy your brake lines ready-made at your local auto supply store, and they'll come with the flare nut on them and the standard double flare already installed for you there. So what I've done here is taken a standard piece of double wall and cut it in section and polished it up with a diamond file so that we could see how it's folded over onto itself, and that's what's meant by the double flare. And you can see how it's curled back inside. So it in fact has two sealing surfaces now, the inside edge here as well as the face of it right here. And a lot less likely to crack on the radius, which is a common problem for a single flare. So you'll need a double flaring toolkit. I got this nice blue point set from my Snap-on dealer. Okay, so got this little tubing cutter, and in the idler side there are these notches cut into the idler rollers. Okay, and what they're for is so you can load your flare right into that notch in the followers, and now the cutter is just going to take off the very end of it, and that's so you can just remove the flare if you want. Okay, so I've removed the single flare alone just by running it through that little groove on the followers. Okay, so after you've cut it, and then there's three things you need to do to prepare the end. First of which is you need to cut a chamfer on the edge here. So you're either going to do that using a flat file, or you're going to use your bench grinder. Okay, so I generally like to mount my flaring bar right into my vise just to hold things steady, but you can actually do this pretty much freehand if you need to. Flip the flaring bar over. I'm going to take my piece of 3/16. You can see at this end I've already created a nice flare. So now at this end, before I go any further, I'm going to drop one on that way and the other one on the opposite way. See how they're going to have to both work. Right, this one is going to work for this end. This guy's going to work for this end. Okay, so I got those on. I open it up. I'm going to put it in just proud. Just barely. I'm going to do that down this side, then this side, every time. Always going to do the side that the tube is on first, and then the far side. Take my flat file. Just make sure it's got a nice flat top on it. And then I'm going to take my reaming tool. Okay, it's been well prepared by chamfering the edge, leveling the top, and reaming out the inside. Alright, so now I'm going to flip it back over to the correct way. Again, make sure that I've got my flare nuts in place and in the right place. Opposite the end over here. I'm going to put it in the 3/16 loosely. Just holding till I grab the 3/16 anvil, and I'm going to put that beside it and match the height. Alright, so you set the protrusion of your tube from your flaring bar to the same height as the shoulder here on the anvil that is the correct size. In this case, it's 3/16 of an inch. Okay, when you see that you've got the height right, then you're going to tighten the side that's closest, and then the other side. Make sure the bar is nice and square, that it's lined up flat. The only thing you want to lubricate your brake system with is brake fluid. So I keep a little .3 brake fluid in here. So I'm just going to use a little drop of .3. A couple of drops. So you get them set up to be the same height, and then you're just going to drop the anvil in there. Check that it's the right height. Drop it in. Fit the yoke with the flaring cone over the anvil. Get it so that it's nice and straight. And then turn it down by hand. Then turn the flaring cone down on the anvil. Turn the flaring cone down onto the anvil until the anvil is flush with the flaring bar. So then we're going to put the flaring cone directly into the end of the tube. Turn that down until it's flush. And it goes fairly easily. You don't need to use big heavy wrenches or anything to get this done. And that's done. That's what it'll look like. Just going to clean that up with a little brake cleaner and some compressed air. Undo this. Free. As you can see, I've got my flare knot on the end, and there's the finished product, double flared with the flare knot on it. And that's a standard double flare.